Katrevi Conwy has brought to the Palewis really is building on what the council has started, and in terms of, you know, improving it, that it was an area that people wanted to live. I think what hopefully the vision was that it would be an estate that people would want to live in for the next 30 years.
Very helpful client.
Yeah.
I think who had done a great deal of background research and legwork on what they felt was needed, what would be appreciated, and what the residents certainly would like to see. I mean, we are designing for the residents that are here now, but we're also designing for the future, because you don't change these sort of areas on a yearly or annual basis. You don't change them that regularly. You change them long term. So it was important that we were able to draw upon all the requirements and then fit it in with the technical requirements, or, you know, the cans and can'ts, the practical things like changing of levels, for example, altering drainage or respecting the service runs.
My name's Matt Stowe. I'm the Environmental Development Officer. I think overall the project's been a massive success. We only need to ask members of the community to see about the impact that it's had on their lives, and the feel and the atmosphere on the estate has changed completely. Other than it's just been a massive pleasure to work on a project of this scale. With such a large community, over the last 3 years I've met new people, become friends with new people. I can walk around this estate and talk to a lot of different people. It's almost become like a second home in a way. Was intended to be a focal point, you know. We've got the school on the other side. Throwing out time, you must get 100-150 people, parents and children, spilling out onto the road either side, and there was nowhere to congregate. We've just seen with these two young lads now, riding around on here, it's got play value. There was quite a lot of technical aspects that went into that design as well. The fact that there's a huge 625mm concrete drainage pipe running straight through the middle of the feature. We had to design out certain, that's why it's got a raised bed for the central tree. Done in local limestone. The planting reflects the symmetry of a ship's wheel. You can see the compass detail in the paved surface in there. And that tree, the birch, is a West Himalayan birch, Betula utilis jackmontii. It's got a striking white bark to it, and the idea is that that draws the eye down this avenue of trees. I guess we're stood on Pentraeth Community Woodland site. It looks a little overgrown at the moment, but this is one of several projects throughout this scheme where we were looking at extending the life of the project to create a legacy for future generations. Believe it or not, within this long grass somewhere, we've got 1,625 trees consisting of 16 different native species, which was all planted in one day, which is a huge achievement, the more I think about it.
Yes, in the last 3 years we've delivered, you know, a £4 million programme, but a lot of hard work, like Gwyn was indicating, about those community activists in the area being brave enough and bold enough to actually start that conversation.
I think it's a very good idea, particularly the tree planting today is going to make this area look absolutely fantastic.
Okay. And do you like the fact that your school is getting involved?
I do. I think it's very important for our school to get involved in doing something positive and constructive for your future, making your community look very nice.
Okay, thank you. High five.
This was a collaboration between Groundwork North Wales, which is an environmental charity, and residents from the estate. Previously it was a disused footpath, badly overgrown, you couldn't get up here at all. But when you look at the amount of woody species in the hedgerow, it was potentially almost 3 centuries old. The path itself was on several archive maps. So, over a period of months, the guys sort of cleaned it up, scrubbed it all back, cut a lot back. You can see we've got hazel, alders, blackthorn sloes. There's a whole range of things up there. The interpretation board that marks the entrance to the nature trail. It was put together with help from the local school children and just gives an idea of the different types of habitat that you'll be able to spot along the way. You can see as well that they've actually illustrated some of the species of wildlife that you'd be able to typically find along this trail. So it's not just a nice place to walk, it's got an educational value to it as well.
Has exceeded any expectations. It's all well and good seeing things on plans, but actually seeing it in reality, and you know, yes, there's loads to talk about paleoists. If you just look at, you know, the three of the features that have gone in, the large stone at the entrance, the compass, which is a fantastic seating area outside the school. And then the human sundial by the bus stop on Bertha Glyd. I think in a way they're all fantastic in their own rights, and having the three features in a single estate is amazing.
Essentially, it's a human sundial, or an anaglomatic sundial. Residents and the community said they didn't want any trees on this part here because you've got some stunning views of the coast there. So, but they needed something to keep the children occupied whilst they were waiting for the bus. So, I kind of hit on this idea of a human sundial. Like I say, it aligns with their Key Stage 2 core curriculum, their studies. So it's got an educational value to it, but by putting these big old stones round, that also gave it some play value as well and made it into a more substantial design feature. It works on a human being the gnomon, the stick that they cast a shadow. So we have tablets on the floor with the months of the year on, and you'll see that they're colour-coded as well to differentiate between British summertime and Greenwich Mean Time. So it's August now, you stand with your heel to the back of that particular month, and wherever your shadow casts, that's the time. Looks to me as though it's about 5 to 10 to 11 at the moment. It's pretty accurate actually.
Flexibility, I would have said, was one of the major aims. We had to have a flexible approach from the local authority, and we really tried hard to get them on site to see the practical aspects of what we were trying to achieve, so that they could see firsthand the difficulties of such a development, retrofitting it almost, and to see how pragmatic and how helpful I think everybody was trying to be to get the scheme through. Well, a design is never fixed until it's fixed. In other words, it will always evolve, and it would continue to evolve even when it's being constructed on the ground, and that's rightly so. You never ever design something that doesn't ever need a little bit of tweaking. This scheme, we wanted to have the flexibility of the tweaking, for want of a better word, because of the difficulty of trying to retrofit a new scheme and working with the levels. So I hate to think how many versions we had, and each time we had a revised version, or we had some feedback, or we had some comments, the schedule of works had to be remeasured and amended, and keeping on top of that was a difficult process, a normal process, but still a difficult and time-consuming process. But then you've got to do that to give a degree of surety of cost, both for the contractor and for the client.
I'm looking forward to the park because more people go out and play instead of go on games.
When I first came on the estate, I noticed that there was huge gaps. There was no provision for toddlers. There was very little provision for those children in between kind of like the active play stages and the social play stages. So we looked at how we could extend the provision of that play to make the migration as smooth as possible.
The thing that I'm really curious about from you guys is, what do you think is the most interesting thing that we're doing up here, and that you'll enjoy the most when you're living or walking through the area?
I'm going to really enjoy like the stone at the entrance of Park Violet.
Yeah.
I'm going to enjoy the skate park. It's like I'm a schoolgirl.
I'm gonna enjoy the skate park in the park.
I'm gonna enjoy the skate park, but I do like the trees and all the flowers that are in the
park. I'm gonna enjoy the skate park.
I'm gonna enjoy the park because I think more people will come out and just sit down and play on games.
I'm gonna enjoy the skate park and the stones.
I'm just looking forward to see how pretty it is.
This is an turned around community. You know, this is transformation, truly transformation. And I think it's inspirational as well in relation to what we've achieved. And I think it does replicate kind of best practice or exemplar that can be, you know, shared with our partners, you know, in North Wales or across Wales or across the UK. There are so many memories, you know, of that kind of time when I was on there. You know, one of them, you know, was, you know, when I went up there, I was on the top end of the estate, and a little child came out, the boy came out, and he came up and he said, "I just want to tell you one thing about this estate." And I wound down the window and he threw his head back, and I didn't know what was going to come out of that, out of his mouth. And he just said, "This is fantastic," the top of his voice. You know, you can't beat that, can you? You just can't beat it. So for me personally, proud of what we've achieved, proud of what we've achieved with the community, proud of what we've achieved internally, you know, with our own colleagues, proud of what we've achieved with the local authority and its partners. And I would hope that, you know, we're able to replicate and undertake similar initiatives across our portfolio in Conway, you know, as resources and time allows, because it can't be allowed to be a one-off. We've got other areas, we've got other priorities now that we can actually invest in, and learn from this. And I think, you know, patience and engagement are going to be two key words.
I like the changes on Park Pilot, and I'm really looking forward to seeing the limestone. And maybe it's going to have some of your Scott and Marion's work on it on the back.
We wanted to put the park into Palewis, I suppose. I will say, but I firmly believe it, we have truly put the park into Palewis.
If you think I wink, I did. Laugh politely at repeats. Yeah, kiss me when my lips are thin. 'Cause holy cow, I love your eyes. And only now I see the light. Yeah, lying with you half away, stumbling over what to say.
Sonic Man!